Hi, my name is Frederik. Welcome to the YouTube channel of Macherei Nagel. In this video, I want to show you how to perform the BOD5 tube test. To perform the BOD5 tube test, you need the test kit itself, which is sufficient for 22 determinations, the BOD5 TT accessory set, graduated cylinder, and piston pipettes with pipette tips. Each test kit comes with two boxes. In box A, you will find the pictogram instructions in the lid. You will also find 22 test tubes with rubber stoppers. In box B, you will find additional reagents and also 22 screw caps for closing the test tubes again. The contents of the BOD5 TT accessory set are instructions, a storage vessel with a red lid, two reaction vessels, an electric air pump, a flexible tube with an aerating brick attached to it, and an extra aerating brick. Before you can start with the measurements, you need to prepare diluting water. For this, you need the accessory set. In a first step, insert the flexible tube through the borehole of the lid and connect the end to the pump. Fill the storage vessel with water. For this, you need unchlorinated tap water. The water must not contain more than 0.0 mg per liter copper, chlorine or chloramine. The pH value should be between 6 and 8. If necessary, adjust the pH with sulfuric acid or sodium hydroxide solution. Close the lid of the storage vessel firmly. Be sure to position the pump always above the water level. Otherwise, water may flow back and damage the pump. Plug in the pump to the mains. The diluting water is aerated at 20 plus minus 2 degrees Celsius in the dark for at least 1 hour. Make sure the concentration of dissolved oxygen in the diluting water is at least 8 mg per liter O2. Switch the air pump off by unplugging it from the mains. The water must not be oversaturated with oxygen. Therefore, leave to stand in an open container for at least 1 hour. After preparing the diluting water, you can now start incubating your samples. Prior to testing, take the needed amount of test tubes out of the box and replace the rubber stopper with the screw caps provided. Remember to take one additional test tube for making the control solution. In a first step, you have to prepare your blank. Measure 20 milliliters of your diluting water and fill it in a reaction vessel. Shake it strongly for 30 seconds to enrich it with oxygen. Take a test tube. Open it and fill it to the brim with a control solution from the vessel without letting air bubbles in. Close the tube with the control solution without letting air bubbles in. Mark the tube as control. Incubate in a water bath or an incubator for 5 days at 20 plus minus 1 degree Celsius in the dark. As an alternative, put it in a dark room with a room temperature of approximately 20 degrees Celsius. According to the expected BOD value, prepare a dilution of your sample and the diluting water directly in the reaction vessel. For the correct dilution, please refer to the table in the leaflet of the test kit. Check for the most suitable dilution and read the volume of sample and diluting water. Close the vessel. Shake it strongly for 30 seconds to enrich it with oxygen. Take a test tube, open it, and fill it to the brim with a diluted water sample without letting air bubbles in. Close the test tube without letting air bubbles in. After this, mark it as the sample tube. Now, incubate it at 20 degrees in the dark for 5 days. After 5 days of incubation at 20 degrees in the dark, the concentration of dissolved oxygen must be determined. For this, you need all incubated test tubes, as well as the reagents from the box B. First, take the control solution tube. Open the test tube and add 2 drops of R1. Also add 2 drops of R2. Close the tube and shake it. Now wait 2 minutes. After exactly 2 minutes, open the test tube again and add 5 drops of R3. Flakes will form now. Close without letting any air bubbles in. Shake the tube until all flakes are dissolved. Take your control tube and clean it from the outside. Then, put it in your photometer and press 0. Now, repeat the steps adding the reagents to the sample tube. Take your sample tube and clean it from the outside. Put it in the photometer and press measure. Enter the dilution factor and the device will show the BOD5 of your sample. Typical interferences are iron 2 salts, sulfur dioxide and sulfur hydrogen. They consume oxygen and falsify the BOD5 results, which will result in lower findings. Remove free and or bounded chlorine by addition of sodium sulfide. If the sample does not contain enough suitable microorganisms, then so-called inoculating water is added to the diluting water. More information can be found on the instructions of the accessory set. The dilution water and the sample should have a pH in the range of 6 to 8. You can use our pH fix test strips to check the pH of the sample. In case of any precipitation, please use our membrane filtration kit to filter your sample. Analytical quality control can be done with the NanoControl BOD5 standard solution. For measurements with this standard solution, you will need inoculated dilution water. Thanks for watching this video. Feel free to subscribe to this channel and hit the notification bell so you won't miss any upcoming videos. If there are still open questions, please contact us via phone or mail.